In 1961, the Rangers selected a little-known left wing from Chicago's reserve list in the old Original Six intra-league draft. The scouting report said he was a tough guy who would make sure nobody messed with his teammates. While he did lead the league with 151 penalty minutes in 1963-64, then coach and general manager Emil Francis knew there was more to his game, and by decade's end, he was already a Rangers legend. Vic Hadfield became the heart and soul of a Rangers team that either won or tied three out of every four games at the Garden from 1967 to 1974. As a member of the gag line, he posted 30 multiple goal games, including a 1971 playoff hat trick against the Chicago Blackhawks. Named captain in June of 1971, Vic became the Rangers' first 50-goal scorer and helped power the Blue Shirts to their first Stanley Cup final in 22 years. It was no surprise when Vic received the Rangers' 1971-72 Players' Player Award and was selected to play for Team Canada in the epic 1972 Summit Series against Russia. Off the ice, his sense of humor and compassion drew the respect and love of his teammates. Maybe Emil Francis said it best. Any coach would take 10 Hadfields on his team. He's that kind of player. Vic left the Rangers in 1974 after playing 841 regular season games and 62 playoff games. He went on to reach two NHL milestones while in Pittsburgh, 300 career goals and 1,000 career games before his playing days ended in 1977. Ever loyal to his teammates, Vic Hadfield remains a leading member of the Rangers Alumni Association. Few men have given so much to this organization over the past six decades. So fittingly, tonight, Vic Hadfield receives the New York Rangers' highest honor. It's now my privilege to introduce our greatest legends who have gathered tonight to celebrate Vic Hadfield and all he has meant to the Rangers organization. Representing the great Andy Bathgate, a Hall of Famer who we sadly lost in 2016, and the one and only Harry Howell, also a Hall of Famer who cannot be here tonight, is Harry's daughter, Cheryl. And now, please welcome Rangers legends, number one, Eddie Jockeman. Number 35. Mike Richter. Number 11, Mark Messier. Number 2, Brian Leetch. Number 9, Adam. Adam Graves. Number 7, Rod Gilbert. And number 19, Jean Rattel. And now, I am deeply honored to introduce the ultimate teammate, a legendary New York Ranger. Please welcome back to Madison Square Garden, number 11, Vic Hadfield. Some of your former Rangers teammates and good friends are here tonight to be a part of this very special celebration. He played his entire 16-year career with the Rangers and ranked second in franchise history in goals, assists, and points by a defenseman, former Rangers captain Ron Greschner. He was the first player in NHL history to score a hat trick in consecutive games and still holds the Rangers' record for most points in a single game with 7. 1973 NHL Rookie of the Year, Steve Vickers. He served as captain of the Rangers from 1965 to 1971 and was a four-time NHL All-Star, Bob Nevin. He played parts of 4 seasons with the Rangers, recording 135 points in 220 games, and was an important part of the Rangers team that advanced to the Stanley Cup Final in 1971-72. Bruce McGregor. He played 6 seasons with the Blue Shirts and won the Players' Player Award in 1973-74, Ted Irvin. He played parts of 9 seasons with the Rangers and was a finalist for the Calder Trophy as the NHL's Rookie of the Year in 1969-70. He helped the Rangers reach the Stanley Cup Final in 1971-72. Bill Fairburn. His triple overtime game-winning goal in Game 6 of the Stanley Cup semifinals in 1971 against Chicago is one of the most memorable goals in Rangers history. Pete Stemkowski. He played his entire 14-year NHL career with the Rangers, ranking 5th on the franchise's all-time games played list and sixth on the franchise's all-time points list. He centered the Bulldog line with Bill Fairburn and Dave Bellon. Walt Tkachuk. He played alongside Vic for 12 seasons with the Rangers and ranks among the top 10 in Blue Shirts history in games played, goals, assists, and points by a defenseman. He played in two NHL All-Star games and assisted on Vic's 50th goal. Jim Nielsen. And he spent eight seasons with the Blue Shirts, was a nine-time NHL All-Star, and became the first defenseman in franchise history to score 20 goals in a season. Here is Hall of Famer Brad Park. Thank you, gentlemen, for being with us tonight, and thank you for your incredible contributions to the Rangers and the game of hockey over your celebrated careers. And at this time, we'd like to present Vic with a few special gifts. On behalf of the Rangers organization, Rod and Eddie are presenting Vic with a specially inscribed commemorative watch that reads, "The Ultimate Teammate, a Legendary Ranger." This watch symbolizes 93 years of Rangers history and the unbreakable link among all legendary players. Vic, we now ask that you turn your attention to the Ranger Zone. As Rangers alternate captains Jesper Fast, Mark Stahl, Chris Kreider, Matt Zuccarello, and Mika Zibanejad make their way to your next gift. We know how much you like to battle along the boards, so on behalf of the retired Blue Shirt legends and all your former teammates, we'd like to present you with a standard size NHL Dasher board featuring the 132 names of your Rangers teammates during your storied career. We know all your teammates thank you for the many successful battles you waged on their behalf while digging the puck out of the corner. And now, here to present Vic with his final gift, the coach and architect of the great Rangers teams in the late 60s and early 70s. His 342 wins are the most by any head coach in Rangers history. Please welcome back to Madison Square Garden, Hockey Hall of Famer, Emil the Cat Francis. And Vic, because we know how much you appreciate your time with your family, we'd like to present you with a five-day cruise courtesy of Royal Caribbean and the New York Rangers. And now, let's get a few words from the Cat.
How are you?
Good to see you. I'm so thrilled to be back at Madison Square Garden. And with all the good hockey fans, the best hockey fans in the world, right here in Madison Square Garden. It was such an honor to have the opportunity to spend so many years here in New York and to work at Madison Square Garden. I've always said they were the best years of my life. Thank you, and thank you, the players that played for me. All of you. I was the luckiest guy in the world to have these fellows here for all those years. Of course, there's a lot of things I didn't know about. It's been a year since we were last here. Where does time go, especially when you're having so much fun? The big reason why the gag line was aligned in Rangers history. I'm so proud now that all three of their names will be together up on the roof. Vic, you were so, I'm so proud that you were so good. You could do everything. You could fight, you could score goals, you could cause all kinds of problems. You were a great guy, Vic. This is so well deserved, and I'm so happy for you and your family. Congratulations to the family, all of you. And now I would like to pass this microphone to one of the best, of course, John Rattel. John?
Thank you, Milton. Great.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, isn't it Milton Francis great? You're right, I think it's fantastic. It's a great honor for Rod and me to be here with all of you at Madison Square Garden to celebrate our good friend and line mate, number 11, Vic Hadfield. Vic's family and my family were very close. In the early years, Vic and Myrna's daughters, Michelle and Julie, were 3 and 2 years old and loved Barbie dolls. They could not say Mr. and Mrs. Rattel, so they called us instead Mr. and Mrs. Mattel. Their girls thought my wife Nancy and I owned the toy company. Our wives were close. Our kids were the same age, and Myrna Hadfield was a great cook. Whoop, got the wrong page. There we go. After a long road trip, at the next practice, Vic would come to me and say, "Your family was over for dinner again. I'm gonna have to put a lock on the fridge." Of course, Vic was known for eating Myrna's pot roast all by himself. Vic always said he had to carry me on his back, so he had to eat well. Fast forward a couple of years to 1972, where we were in Moscow to beat the Russians, and we brought our own steaks for pregame meals. Apparently, the Russian chef thought those steaks were way too big, so he cut them in half and served them to us. Well, someone went back to the kitchen to find the rest of our food, and the chef was gone. And there was a big old padlock on the fridge. Myrna and Nancy were laughing because Vic would be happy there was a lock on the fridge. Vic was a rare breed of hockey player. He was the epitome of a power forward. Good skater, passes well, makes plays, aggressive in the corners, can fight, and most importantly, has a great shot and can score goals. Vic Hadfield was the first in New York Rangers history to score 50 goals in a season. Hey, Rod. Hey, Rod, do you think Vic was that good?
He was better than that.
He was great. Over the years, I've often been asked what my fondest memory of playing with the Rangers was. My answer was always the same. It was playing for a great Ranger team and playing a long time with two great players of the caliber of Rod Gilbert and Vic Hadfield. Our line had great chemistry and we made each other better players. It will be a privilege and an honor for the three of us to be together again up there in the rafters. It is also the highlight of my career. It doesn't get any better than this. Thank you to the Rangers organization and to you, the fans, for being here this evening. Congratulations, Vic. It is well deserved. Thank you all and God bless.
Somebody said, speak English. Good evening, everyone. I told you last season, I stood here before you and I announced that the gag line would be immortalized in the rafter, and the day is now, it's come. So, can't get better than that. Today is the day. Well, it's always great to be here with my great friend Vic. What can I say? We know each other since my days when I was a Rangers and I played at Guelph. That is where many Rangers, guys like Harry Howell, number 3, Andy Bathgate, number 9, and that's where they played in Guelph, like before me. So I was playing with the Biltmores with Jean Rattel, and one of our opponents was the Blackhawks junior team at St. Catharines. They had a rugged and physical left wing named Vic Hadfield, who played on their top line, and boy, was he a tough customer. And he was a little bit obnoxious, actually. But, you know, I mean, like, he was hard to play against. And I like that part of it. So, Guelph also is where we first played for the Cat. We have so many memories we have together. Thank you for being here, Emil. Actually, it was Emil that brought Vic to the Rangers. That was such an important step for the growth of our team. Vic complimented both of us so well, but I won't hold it against him that he helped his St. Catharines teammate, Chico Mackey, win the scoring title over me by 1 point in 1960. I never forgot that. I can't believe it. I will tell you that even though we were line mates and great friends on and off the ice, sometimes Jean and I would talk to each other in French. And Vic would get frustrated and he'd say to us, speak English. I said, no, we're talking about you. I would always say that. Now, to see Vic's number 11 go up there with Jean and I is pretty amazing, actually. It's not something that you try for or when you play, or you don't think about that. But the three of us are pretty humble about our success. But this recognition means a lot to us collectively, believe me. And also, I would like, thank you. It means a lot, tremendous. Also, we want to thank Mr. Dolan and Mr. Glenn Sather and the Rangers organization for this fantastic event. Now, here comes the best. You guys out there are the best hockey fans, and when the New York fans recognize that we were truly a trio and together we were successful, so it is especially befitting to see Vic honored too in that fashion. So I would like to call my friend over and receive this wonderful homage and join us in the rafter. Please welcome Mr. and my wonderful teammate, Vic Hadfield.
Wow, what a feeling. Thank you for this wonderful honor. Thank you, everyone. Thank you to the Ranger organization, Glenn Sather, my great teammates, and all the wonderful Ranger fans through the generations who supported me and all of us. A special thank you to Rod and John. I certainly wouldn't be able to be here today without you two. Thank you, John, Rod. I can't explain how incredible and amazing it is to stand before you and accept this tribute tonight. This is such an honor, a privilege for any player. I want to thank Emil Francis for his guidance, his spirit, and his will to win. Thank you, Emil. My time in New York was very special beyond the ice. I became friends with many of the Knick greats too. So to know that I'll be across from their banners as well is a tremendous bonus. With Rod and John's style and grace, I really did have a tough time keeping up with them, but they supported me and we got it done. And the bond between us to this day remained very strong. And when we speak or get together, it really feels like no time has passed. We have all been a family for a long, long time. And this night really brings everything full circle for me and my family. I wouldn't be here without him. We all wish Myrna. All the best back home. She did a great job raising our kids, and I'm so happy my son and Jeff and my daughter Julie, as well as my grandchildren, are here with me tonight. I also have a lot of close friends from down from Canada tonight. And I don't really understand how a lot of them got across the border. Coming from Canada, all I wanted to do is to play hockey. I was very determined. I may not have had the ability to skate like a lot of the guys, but I figured out if I was going to play the game, I had to play aggressive. When I first put on the Ranger sweater, and that was a highlight of being able to accomplish what I set out to do. Nobody was going to tell me I couldn't play, and I was going to do whatever I had to do to help the team win and be successful. You had to earn your points every game, and we struggled in my earlier years with the Rangers. But if you worked hard and the fans saw you were trying, they always supported us. That always meant the world to me at the old Madison Square Garden and here at MSG, the world's most famous arena. I want to take a moment here. One of our teammates, Jill Villemure, is having a rough time health-wise, and I know all the alumni, the New York fans, wish him a speedy recovery. To the New York Rangers and their great fans, you will always have a special place in my heart. Thank you all so very, very much. I'm humbled by the opportunities that come our way in this game. I sincerely wish that everyone here experiences something, anything in your life that makes you feel like I do right now. This is the highest honor a player can receive, and thank you again from the bottom of my heart.
Thank you, Vic. It is humbling for all of us to hear how much the Rangers have meant to you. And now, to begin our ceremony, Vic's children, Jeff and Julie, will hand off the number 11 banner to Rod and John, who will escort it to its destination, where it will ascend to the garden ceiling. We invite members of the Hadfield family to join Vic on the ice. Vic's son, Jeff, is joined by his wife, Patricia, and their three children, Victor, Teresa, and Alexandra. Vic's daughter, Julie, is joined by her son, Ben, and his wife, Stacy. The moment we've been waiting for. Vic Hadfield will take his well-earned place in Rangers immortality. Vic, your name will grace the garden rafters forever, inspiring excellence, loyalty, and commitment in all that takes place here. Rangers history. We wish you and yours the very best. Ladies and gentlemen, representing almost 60 years of Rangers pride, passion, and tradition, an inspiration for all who are privileged to wear the Rangers jersey and represent the greatest fans in the greatest city in the world. For one last time tonight, here are our heroes, the retired jerseys of Rangerstown.
I'm going to